does it matter? The most important thing is that the baby's back.
Yeah. Poor little mite. I hope she's all right. Them bloody rotten mongrels that molest little kids.
Morris will be working in the laundry from now on. Find her something to do, will you, Smith?
Yeah, okay. You can give Mouse a hand with those sheets, Tracy.
Okay.
How come you're here?
I've got to work somewhere.
They're shorthanded in the kitchen. Funny Fletch didn't send you there.
He was going to, but asked to work in the laundry.
Oh, wonder why.
I wanted to work with my friends, Bea and Lizzie.
And Judy?
Shut up, Mouse.
Oh, don't say that. I was just going to suggest I change places with Judy. You get nice and close, folding sheets.
Lay off, Mouse.
But I suppose you can wait till smoke, eh? There's a nice warm little corner over there by the dryers. Just the place for a kiss and a cuddle.
I said lay off. One more word out of you about Judy and Tracy.
What are you getting so hot under the collar for?
Well, get regular, Bea! Oh, shut up. And that goes for the rest of you too.
Okay, okay. Funny, isn't it? Wonder why Bea's getting so touchy about Lizzo's.
I want to ask to be moved out of the laundry.
Really? May I ask why?
Well, I thought you would have guessed. Tracy Morris.
I'm a prison officer, not a social worker. I'm not going to rearrange things to suit your social life.
Look, I thought I got through to you. You know why I wanted Tracy moved out of my cell, and then you go and detail her to the laundry.
Get your facts straight. Morris made the request herself.
Oh.
Besides, being on the same work detail is not as bad as sharing a cell.
I wonder what got into her. Anyway, that doesn't matter. I still want her out of the laundry.
Look, it's not up to the inmates to decide where they'll go and what they'll do. Now get it straight. Do as you're told.
Okay. But she's being hassled by those women. There's no point in me adding fuel to the fire. Look, it's for her sake.
Well, would the workshop suit you?
Yeah. Anywhere but the laundry's fine.
Good. I'm glad somebody's happy.
Thanks, Mr. Fletcher. I really appreciate it.
Come on. I'll help you make your bed.
I'm not just going with Bea, Lizzie.
I'm sorry, Doreen, but you heard what the governor said. It's for your own good.
Yeah, maybe she's right. After what I've done, they probably wouldn't want to know me anyway. They don't like people who hurt little kids.
Now, that's not why you're here. And you didn't hurt that baby.
Yeah, but I might have.
You're not to think like that, Doreen. You'll only upset yourself. Come on, let's make the bed.
They think I'm mental, don't they? That's why they're going to lock me away from everybody.
It's only for observation.
Please, Mrs. Jackson, I promise I won't do anything silly, but I just don't want to be left here all by myself.
I'm sorry, Doreen, but you have to stay here until you see Dr. Wiseman. Now, there's an officer on duty at all times in this wing, so you only have to call out if you need anything. I'm sorry. I have to go. Just reporting on Doreen. I've taken her to the nurse for medication and she's now in isolation.
How's she coping?
Well, she didn't like the idea of being alone.
Oh, I wish I knew what to do with her. Well, let's hope Dr. Wiseman will be able to help.
She handled the confrontation with Chrissy pretty well under the circumstances.
Yes, that was a start, thank heaven.
Any idea when the baby will be back?
In a few days. That child seems to be as tough as her mother.
Well, is there anything else?
Vera Bennett, I've received a medical certificate for her, which means she can take sick leave.
You don't sound very happy about it.
No, it may be no solution at all. What do you think, Meg?
I wish I knew. I know one of the reasons why she drinks, and that's because she's so lonely.
Well, sick leave isn't going to help, is it? What she obviously needs is to be with people.
I'll go and visit her this afternoon. We're friends, of sorts.
I'd appreciate that, Meg. I don't want to lose a good officer, but if this keeps up, I'm afraid I will.
I didn't know there was anyone in isolation.
Now, don't loiter. You've still got the solitary meals to deliver.
Some poor loony, probably. It's a crime locking a body up in a hole like this.
Oh! Oh, if I couldn't believe my own eyes. When did you get back? What happened? What'd you do?
Oh, it's too awful, Lizzie.
Can't be that terrible that you couldn't tell your old Lizzie. Nothing's that bad.
You must have heard about it.
Not a word, but the screws are as tight as fishes.
Yeah. Well, it was on TV. Last night it was on TV.
Chrissy's baby? Oh, you never. They're trying to frame you. It's easy to pick on someone who's been a jailbird.
It was me, Lizzie.
Why?
Oh, because I thought they were going to put her in a home.
Oh, I knew there'd be some good news. There, love. There. Your old Lizzie understands even if nobody else does. Rotten mongrels. Putting you in here to cry your little eyes out.
It's for my own good, Lizzie.
Rotten mongrels. You ought to be with someone who can take care of you like me and B.
Yeah, but I don't mind much. Now that I know you two don't hate me for what I've done. And they're going to let me talk to that Dr. Wiseman. Then they'll know what to do with me.
But you're not a loony, love. All you need is to be among your friends.
That's what?
Oh, here comes old ferret face.
Now, I told you not to loiter. Get moving.
I'm coming. Now, don't you worry, love. I'll set him straight. You'll be out of here before you can say Jack Robinson.
See? Oh. Tracy, buy up time.
I'm not interested.
I think it's about time we had a little talk, don't you?
If you're looking for an apology...
I said a talk. Now, I know you're very upset before, but I think...
How much do you own a year, Mrs. Jackson?
What?
$12,000, $13,000. Not much for a lady like you.
Now, what's that got to do?
But you won't have to worry anymore because Dad's got plenty. You'll be nice and comfortable. You won't have to come along to a place like this every day to earn a crust because Dad's got pots to support you.
I'm sorry you don't like the idea of my relationship with your
father. I'm stuck with it anyway.
I'm not sure you understand, Tracy.
I understand, all right. I lose in every way. Just when Dad and I were getting on so well, I find I have to take the rap. So someone has to console him, don't they? And who's there? It must have been so easy just picking up the pieces, making up for all he's lost. It's not so much as losing a daughter as finding a wife.
How dare you?
Easily. The only person I've ever cared about in my life has been taken away by some scheming, conniving, money-hungry screw.
I am not after
his
money.
You saw a good thing and you went all out to get it. You've really set yourself up well, haven't you? The truth hurts, Mrs. Jackson, doesn't it?
Oh, hello, mate. I thought you were distributing buy-up.
Yes, George Barry's just taken over from me.
Hey, what's wrong?
Just a bit of a shock, that's all.
More than a bit by the look of you. Do you want to talk about it?
Tracy's just informed me that I'd got my claws into her father because of his money and that I deliberately set out to take him away from her.
That little bitch. Did you put her on insulin's charge?
There's no solution, Jim. I mean, what can I do? I'm practically a stepmother.
So you are going to marry Bob, then?
Yes, I am. Tracy's so resentful. How can I marry Bob with that hanging over my head?
Ah, she'll get over it. And even if she doesn't, that's her problem, not yours. Think of yourself for a change instead of putting everyone else's feelings first.
But can't you see, Jim? I have got to consider Tracy. I mean, she's going to be here for some time.
Look, you'd marry Bob if his daughter wasn't in Wentworth, right?
Yes, I would.
Well, there you are, then. Your answer's right in front of you. Don't let Wentworth get in the way of your real feelings.
But, Jim, it's not that simple. I mean, you had to give up Jackie because of Wentworth.
Yeah, well, that's different. The regulations state that I can't have anything to do with her. I've got no choice in the matter. You have.
Hi. I come looking for you. We missed you at the buy-up.
How was Mrs. Jackson? Usual sweetness and light.
Oh, well, Barry was on duty.
Must have had to cover for her. She's probably crying her eyes out somewhere.
Now, what are you on about?
I told her what I thought of her. That I knew she was only feathering a nest by latching onto Dad. That really set her back.
And do you believe that?
How do I know? She could be.
Honey, I thought we'd straightened all this out ages ago. I mean, hasn't it ever occurred to you that Meg Jackson might love your father, and he might love her?
He loves me. If he marries that bitch, he won't have time for me anymore. I was going to be so good. Then she comes along and spoils it all.